very well with the Death Prophet. I think that was something that was definitely lacking from last game. We saw how many times they would try and cut creep waves, but what the AI did was say, that's fine, we'll just tank the creep wave and not let any damage happen to the tower. Zeb's in trouble.
Indeed, we see a quick heads-up play there from the CM, utilizing the Mango to instantly get the mana required for Frostbite. Zeb will survive, but taking a lot of heavy harass here from this duo lane of the Gyro and Crystal Maiden. Back towards mid, Thompson actually nearly dying here. In fact, well, he does. The poison was too much. And there's 2 points there in the poison attack. Oh, that is absolutely true. And we're seeing once again in these first few minutes in terms of the farm, people are coming out pretty even in CS. Down bottom, Seb's in trouble though. Gyro takes the kill. Seb did commit for the Crystal Maiden, but OpenAI taking the favorable trade.
True usage.
I'll see up top. Turn here with the Maledictor onto Ana. Ana has got the Dark Pact. They do have a Viper in this lane as well now, so OG have to be careful. Again, the Gyrocopter just racking up these kills. He was able to kill off Jerax once more. As this chase continues top, South will be popped, but he gets cancelled here by the stun. OpenAI diving past the tower with the damage from the Viper and the Sven. They'll claim the Slark's life. They'll get no tail as well. The AI turning it up early here in this game too.
Forward at like 150 HP. Like, Thompson took like 250 HP just from one poison attack and Nether Toxin.
And Ana is having a very tough time here on this top lane as he dies once more. 6 minutes in, OpenAI taking this tier one tower.
A lot more dominant in the lane.
I mean, Seb, he's trying to kill this Crystal Maiden, but the Crystal Maiden is just baiting Seb in. The backup's there from the Gyrocopter, and this combo that's causing issues for Seb in the lane will continue to cause issues as the game continues. Seb will try and juke it out around the trees. He's doing a pretty good job of it.
Oh, no way!
He's outshooting the AI. Seb will escape with a TP out. He's outplayed the AI. Have the damage output to immediately kill him. They will find the follow-up wraparound kill onto towards him. At least they're trying, but with that Warcry out, he's able to run away. Another Fissure comes out. Surely this kill's going to be there, but no, a stun from the Sven holds back the Shaker, and he TPs out on 30 HP. OpenAI gets out of there with the Sven.
In creep ways, but he just couldn't really get to that.
And we see there the side, Jarrett's trying to step forward, but they turn immediately towards him. They have the Viper Strike out upon him. Shrapnel's down here from Thompson in an attempt to hold. Assassinate will not get the kill off, and now again the CM goes for the ult, but they do have the disable. Hex comes out from No Tail. They'll kill up the Crystal Maiden, but OpenAI Viper diving past the tower on towards Thompson. The Sven coming back in on minimal HP to throw that stun off, secure the kill. As OpenAI again getting the favorable trade, another tower taken. They are playing at a ferocious speed here in the second game. Thompson does have backups, but both No Tail and Jerax splitting OpenAI apart as Jerax will focus the Viper. Seb comes in with the TP. They have surrounded the Sven. OpenAI trying to stand their ground as this Sven, but he's stuck in the trees. They'll lose the Sven, OpenAI. The Viper's still good to fight, and they've also now rotated in the Gyrocopter. Seb caught on the front lines. Siphon will not keep him alive, or will it? He gets a second one out. It's a good amount of sustain, but surely not enough, as the poison will be there for on the Viper. OpenAI getting both of the kills. OpenAI as it is, they're not going to make mistakes. They're not going to throw away this lead. You have to outplay them. You have to outmaneuver them. And at this rate, OG, they're struggling to certainly do that as they'll lose Tops and Seb trying to move in. But the Crystal Maiden with that massive amount of damage coming out from the ultimate just stands her ground, too dead. There will be a buyback here as Tops and trying for some OpenAI-esque tactics to try and bring the game back around. But I don't know how much this buyback's going to do for him if they're still without Seb. As Seb just failing to have any sort of impact this game as the Death Prophet after a terrible laning stage against the Gyrocopter and the Crystal Maiden. OpenAI, 14 minutes in, they're up to the high ground, onto the tier 3 tower. Ana will be able to jump away, doesn't even manage to kill off the courier. The Viper godlike diving past towers, killing off Thompson. It's a dieback from the sniper. Seb, he's going to try and leap forward, but the cast bounces are out. Seb stands too close to Jerax. Jerax is in trouble as well as he's forced away. OpenAI taking that top tier 3 tower. They're onto the barracks. It's only 14 minutes in, Cap. 15 minutes in, taking a barracks. An incredibly fast timing here from the AI. Jerax will fall as he tries to get some damage out onto the Viper, but the poison is too much for this underfarmed, underleveled Shaker. No Tail will try and get back. Seb attempting everything to hold them off with the Siphons, with the Crypt Swarm, but he doesn't have the damage. He does not have the HP to survive. Seb is dead. The Rack's taken and OpenAI.
When it comes to once they sense they have an advantage and go for objectives, they min-max their positioning as much as possible. We're going to watch Jerax probably die again.
Yep, and almost certainly Seb as well. Jerax does not have the damage. Seb does have Ana with him, but this Slark only has Treads and a Wraith Ban. There's nothing he can do. He's got a Shadow Dance popped. He will be able to steal up a bit of Essence Shift, but the cast bounces out onto Notel. Stun as well, out onto the Slark. Triple kill for the OpenAI Viper. Thompson, he's desperately looking for this Crystal Maiden, but the movement's here with the Shadow Amulet dancing herself away, utilizing the Invis to make sure that Thompson cannot get that final hit on her. Continuing to use the Amulet, getting away out of this. Thompson, can he find this? He does get the vision for the Assassinate, but there's the disable. The stun comes out from the cast, cancelling the Assassinate. The Crystal Maiden kept safe and alive. 17 minutes in, there looks like there's very little chance of OG turning this one around. They will find the Witch Doctor pushing out alone. They may be able to at least claim the life of a Witch Doctor. Can they get more though? No, the Crystal Maiden again using the ult. Enchant Totem comes out with the Aftershock, does cancel the Onimo from the CM. Finger comes out, but it's not enough damage to kill off the Crystal Maiden. There'll be buybacks from both sides. Notail gets back in, so does the OpenAI Witch Doctor. As OpenAI wants to continue the aggression, the Gyro up onto the high ground, past the tier 3, past the barracks, playing so aggressive here. Seb has to be careful of potential wraparounds. They're pushing in both lanes at the same time, the AI. Both the middle lane and the bottom lane under threat. Also, the team as well of OG getting dove upon up past the tier 4s. Ana's trying to commit in. OpenAI, they're low, but they have the heals. The Voodoo Restoration from the Witch Doctor, meaning that OG cannot finish off any of these kills. Ana will fall again on the Slark. He has got a buyback. He will use it. But OG, they are just crumbling and getting entirely crushed here in this game too. It looks like there's very little chance for them to play anything back in response, as once again, AI just collapse onto OG. They cannot fight back at this point. Their heroes, their draft, it does nothing when OpenAI's heroes are this far ahead. He wasn't doing what you'll see sort of the Samaels of today do. He's playing in the action, in the lanes. This ain't no AFK jungle. Seb's calling out the Smurfs. But OpenAI,
I mean, between the poison attack and the corrosive skin, right, it was just so hard for OG to be able to fight against that. Like, they put the Viper on the front lines always, and they just couldn't sit back and just, you know, use the Sniper and the Earthshaker to be able to kill creep waves and then have the Slark cut. Like, that was the ideas that OG was hoping for, but, and always forcing the fight.
I mean, if they can get this kill, it would be an absolutely huge run. He's 18-09 at the moment, but they cannot. They do not have any sort of damage to beat down this Viper, as once again, OG just getting absolutely floored in any attempt of a team fight.
AI, like, they never...
The trees come out. The offerings as well of mangoes to try and keep the OpenAI at bay, as OG almost certainly conceding here in this game too. I mean, 40-6, 19 minutes in. We have not seen OpenAI look this good. This is such an improvement over time. It's in the past, the build-up. At this point, OpenAI are looking to play at full power.
Yeah, it just looks fantastic. I wonder, do they have a four staff or
something? If they get this kill, it's worth so much.
But they're not getting it. Owen?
They're not getting
it. Can they even do it?
This Viper will not die.
Every single time you think like, oh, this hero, he's too far forward, he's too low, he's gonna get picked off, but there's always enough heroes behind him. Like, even in that situation, they were all the way over by the shrine, but they know that the Viper is just gonna take so long to eventually die that that they could be there in time.
And with the Ancient falling, there is no hope here for OG. They have a fortification, but with Ana dead, 41k lead. They're asking for the finishing blow to come in from the OpenAI, as OpenAI almost playing around with them at this point. Finger attempted onto the Gyro, the stun from Notail misses. Thompson's AFK, he's had enough of this one. As the Ancient will fall, and that is GG, game over. OpenAI taking game two, taking the series 2-0. But honestly, this second game in particular,